Hey guys, Iron Pine here on the Comrade SMP for yet another episode, and I am excited to be on the server tonight. As always, it has been a really long time since I have last been on the server. And first thing you're probably noticing is this big old crane over here of Anders. He has indeed almost finished his crane. It looks like he might be needing a couple more coal blocks over in this zone. But his crane is looking awesome. I definitely encourage you to go check out his episode, where he kind of explains the process of him building his crane. So his crane is looking great right now. And I apologize if there's any frame lag right now. I've really been having some troubles with Minecraft lately. I'm not playing as much, but when I am playing, I'm getting extreme frame rate lag, which is really not fun. But anyways, in today's episode, we are going to be trying to make a good chunk of progress on the interior of our house. We have finished the wall that surrounds the Iron Woods. I know we've done it. It's crazy to think that we have finished this wall. I got a little bit of help from Unirider, but we have gone all the way from here over to the other boundary of the Iron Woods. We have done a lot of this off camera after my last episode, because I didn't want to do any more of this wall building on camera with you guys. I know y'all have had enough of this wall by now. So we'll be working on the interior of our base today, and that is in preparation for some new projects that we will be starting on the server. We recently had a meeting where we discussed the future of the communal area, which at the moment is kind of non-existent. I want to chop this tree down here. So we will be beginning work on the communal area within the next couple days, probably. So that'll be within an episode or two for you guys. And there's another project that I want to build at some point, but I will keep that a secret for now, so y'all can look forward to that. But that will be, that's in the long run, you could say here. But anyways, let's go ahead and walk in F5 for a little bit. You can see we have the wall coming here by Promethean's path, or the path to Promethean's base, and right under Mr. Tubular's tree. So at some point I will need to build a gate here. And then the wall goes all the way over here to where the river kind of comes into the ocean. And that's where the wall stops, right about here. So this is the border of the Iron Woods. It kind of stops as this river comes across. So we have finished the wall here, and I'm getting a whole lot of frame rate lag, running around 12 frames a second right now. I think it's probably because of my villager breeder, which I will go off camera and kill a lot of these villagers once we kill the zombie. But anyways, the substance of today's episode, like I said, will be a cave there. Working on the inside of our base, and working on probably putting in an enchanting room and stuff. That way we can finish up our base and not have to worry about that hanging over our heads. So we can get to work on the rest of the projects that we have to do around the server. So I've gotten some sugarcane from Mini Rider's sugarcane farm, and we will begin working on the enchanting room here today. I think we'll probably put it right over here. I want to put some bookshelves and other paraphernalia probably along this line of torches right here. And then we'll have our enchanting table somewhere back in this area. And then more bookshelves right here along with some other decorations. So I'm going to go ahead and get all my stuff together. I'm going to kill some of the villagers and the villager breeder. And I will catch off to that. This is really kind of scary here. All these villagers are staring at me as I'm just like slaying them. He ain't a farmer, is he? Good, no. Yeah, wait, he's a librarian, but he's got a brown coat. That's odd. Oh, it's a double. He's a Fletcher. Anyways, we're just like, whoop, didn't mean to kill that cleric. We're just murdering villagers here because we have to. I mean, this place is overcrowded. Kuya SGA talked to me about it. We really have to do something about this place. I'm just trying not to kill. I know my popularity here in the village is going down, but that doesn't really matter to me. As long as I get a good fisherman, we could probably even just destroy my villager breeder. Whoop. Take that librarian down. Oh boy. This is getting old rather fast, because I'm afraid I'm going to kill my farmer at some point. We'll leave these clerics here, because I have something in mind relative to them. Watch me kill my mending villager, which I don't even have one, but you know. Anyways, continue killing these villagers, and I will catch y'all when we get some... Oh, we didn't need to block that off. And I will catch y'all when we get some plans figured out for the upstairs of our base. Alright, so I've gathered some resources here. It's kind of become like a if you give a mouse a cookie type of situation here. Because I wanted to kill the villagers and the villager breeder. But then I needed some leather and sugarcane to make some more bookshelves. And, you know, things go downhill from there pretty quickly. So about 10 minutes have elapsed since the last clip. But we are here, finally, thankfully. And I'm not sure that I like this pattern, but we'll keep it for now. Here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking dark oak would make a good kind of a borderline here up to the ceiling. And then we'll have layers of bookshelves, maybe two thick in between. It's going to take a lot of bookshelves, but that's okay. And mobs can spawn back here, so we will light this this row in the back up. And we'll kind of do the same thing on the other side, I am thinking. I notice that I'm looking down at the floor a lot as I'm doing this. That is something I'm trying to combat. Obviously, if you look straight on in Minecraft, kind of like I am right now, you get a lot more frame lag, which is not what we're going for. And my axe doesn't have soak touch, but my shovel does. I just realized something that I don't like here. I'm going to break these bookshelves up top with a soak touch shovel. Makes a whole lot of sense in real life, doesn't it? Anyways, we're going to be putting some oak wood up top like this. I think that'll make this look a whole lot better. Then we'll do the same over here. And then we'll put a torch right here. Do likewise. It's been a while since I've actually done any building on camera. I mean, shoot, for that matter, it's been a long time since I've done any building at all. It's been a long time since I've played Minecraft, really. Like, really played Minecraft. But anyways, we'll put some stone bricks down here, I think, to kind of contrast the library a little bit. Give it some stone. There's not enough stone in this room. And then we'll do... Oh, what will we do? We'll have dark oak right here, but you won't really see it, will you? No, we will make you see it. Doing a lot of thinking here. It takes a lot of thinking to run a Minecraft world. But anyways... speaking of Minecraft world, we are the only folks on the server right now. I know some of y'all like to know who all is on the realm when I'm playing. Go ahead and put some more torches down here as we attempt to keep the commentary interesting and keep y'all from skipping on in my videos, which I've probably already failed at that because I'm a very boring commentator. And speaking of that, if you have any tips for how I can get better at this whole YouTube thing, I would love to hear them. I really want to get better at YouTube in general. I am not a great YouTuber myself, but I want to get better. I want to get better at it. That's the main goal here. All right, I think this looks pretty good. We definitely need to put some paintings or item frames or something over here, something of that nature. For the floor, we might leave that as spruce for the moment. Let's throw it on the crafting table because I want to do something with the doorway right here. Doesn't look too good at the moment. I'm thinking spruce stairs. Let's see how that looks. Whoops, wrong placement. I actually lost my soak touch diamond shovel not too long ago, which was really regrettable. But we were doing some PvP on the server probably 4 days ago or so. That's the last time I've actually been on the Comrade SMP for like the Comrade SMP part of it, not like a UHC or something. Oh, that looks even worse. Oh, my pickaxe just broke. But anyways, what I was going to say. Oh yeah, my soap touch pickaxe actually broke. I lost it in the combat, the fray of battle, so I will have to get myself a new one of those at some point. This is not the best entrance possible, but this is the entrance we will go with, I think. The inside of this room looks really cool. Let's go ahead and get some decorations for this room. Let's just put some torches down real quick. Like that. Let's take the ground torches out, see where we lie light level wise. Light of 7. Alright, so this is a creeper spawn zone right here. But let's go ahead and see what types of Oh boy, this is what happens when you have an axe that's much faster than you are. Let's go down and fix that little hole. I have noticed I have a lot of holes in my roof, so I need to go off camera and fix a lot of those. Can we fix this? Gonna have to jump and fix it. Perfect. Anyways, let's get some item frames and maybe what a yeah, item frames would be a good decoration here. As long as we don't get blown up by creepers. Which we'll have to get some leather. We'll make ourselves four item frames. That should be enough. I wanted to let paranoid the spiders can come get me. I wanted to let y'all know of some things I've been thinking about relative to Minecraft lately. I don't know if y'all are all familiar with this, but the Comrade SMP is a Minecraft server where there's no raiding, no griefing, none of that stuff. Basically, we're all friends here. We don't steal anything from each other. That's the way it works. However, when I was a noob at Minecraft, which was probably maybe 5 or 6 months ago, I used to play on a server called the Cloud Vanilla. IP was cobble, like cobblestone, dot biz, so cobble dot biz. And this was a great server. MuniRider and I actually played on that server together, and it is a raiding and a griefing server. And so, we were total noobs, and we got raided and griefed way more than we should have because we were just total noobs. Let's just put an enchanted book down here. This is a pretty rubbish book. What else can we put up in our library to look very cool? I'll put a music disc. Oh, we should put a jukebox up there once we get some music discs. I'm just looking for cool trinkets. Blaze powder is a pretty cool trinket. Oh, I know what we'll put up here. But anyways, so MuniRider and I played on this server, and we had a blast. Playing on it, but we were total noobs. We got raided, we got destroyed in the PvP and all that stuff. But I've thought that it might be cool to either start a survival server or go back on the Cloud Vanilla for just a little bit and enjoy the atmosphere of a kind of a pure survival. Every man for himself, you make alliances with people, but you don't trust anybody. You don't tell people where your base is, you build underground, you rig your base up with traps, kind of deal. Not necessarily factions Minecraft, but in the same genre as factions, you could say. We need to put some light up here somehow. So, anyways, I've just been thinking about that. I may go on there in some of my free time when I'm not recording and play a little bit, but we'll just have to see. Anyways, this looks pretty good for now. I need to do something here. What could I do? Oh, I could put some banners. That'd be a great idea. But anyways, I'm gonna figure out some more detailing here, and I will catch off for that. Well, I have finished my horrible job of decorating. Kind of rearranged the item frames a little bit, added a chest, a trap door with a little seat here that you can sit at and kind of do some reading or whatever you want to do. And then I added this armor stand with some random pieces of armor that I had. So I think this will probably do it for me this episode. I'm glad that we were able to make a room that actually looks halfway decent, if that. But we have the rest of this area to fill up. That will come in the next couple episodes, possibly off camera. I have to figure out what I want to put up there, as well. But at this point, I need to go and get myself a Silk Touch Efficiency 5 pickaxe, as well as a min or a Fortune one. Now that I've lost all of my good old diamond pickaxes. This one just has Unbreaking 3 on it. So I think that will conclude it for me this episode. And I thank you very much for hanging with me here and for bearing with me during the time this past couple week or so where I have not uploaded many episodes from the Comrade SMP. But look forward to more episodes here in the future. Hopefully, I can get my recording schedule to such where I can record more and I can actually enjoy my recording. Because I definitely want to be enjoying this stuff. There's no point in doing it if I'm not. So, anyways, guys, thanks for watching. This has been Iron Pine, and I'm out. I will catch y'all later.